So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. And also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. Aur yahan pe aap koi bhi apne doubts bhi pooch sakte hain and you can get the link of this Telegram group in the description. And we have launched the 2022 course for RBI Grade B and you can avail 30% launch discount by using this code RBI 30. And remember what you will get in the course. So guys, you will get comprehensive video lessons and all the PDFs which are downloadable for both phase 1 and phase 2, 10 mock tests for each subject, finance, management, economics and social issues. Then you will get it for English descriptive and also for the phase 1. And kyunki ab descriptive ho chuka hai ESI aur FM ka, so all your questions, all your answers will be checked by us. And also you will also get a kit that will be delivered at your doorstep. And that includes phase 1 question book, phase 2 question book, phase 2 revision booklet, phase 1 and 2 past year papers, and a notebook and a pen. So a lot of things that you will get through this course. So go to anujindal.in and buy the course. All right, so let's begin with the very first question, which is about: consider the following statements regarding PLI scheme for pharmaceuticals and identify the correct statement. So guys, PLI scheme has been approved for two sectors, pharmaceuticals and IT hardware, recently by the Union Cabinet. So this question is about pharmaceutical sector and question number 2 is about the IT hardware. So let's discuss both the scheme first. First of all, let's talk about the PLI scheme for pharmaceuticals. So as I told you, Union Cabinet has approved the PLI scheme for pharmaceuticals and IT hardware. So remember this. So what is the objective of this scheme, PLI scheme for pharmaceuticals? So we all know the basic objective of PLI scheme, guys, is to boost the manufacturing capabilities. Okay, and since here we are talking about the pharmaceutical sector, so the basic objective of this scheme is to boost the manufacturing capabilities by increasing investment, and production in the pharma sector, and also to provide accessibility and affordability to the मेडिकल प्रोडक्ट्स. जो हमारे मेडिकल प्रोडक्ट्स हैं उसकी एक्सेसिबिलिटी और अफोर्डेबिलिटी को बढ़ाना इज द बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस पीएलआई स्कीम. एंड रिमेंबर व्हाट विल बी द इंप्लीमेंटेशन पीरियड ऑफ दिस 2020-21, व्हिच मींस दिस फाइनेंशियल ईयर टू द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2029, दैट इज 2028-29. राइट. एंड मूविंग अहेड टू द टारगेटेड ग्रुप्स. सो गाइज, द मैन्युफैक्चरर्स आर डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री ग्रुप्स. बेस्ड ऑन वॉट? बेस्ड ऑन देयर ग्लोबल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग रेवेन्यू. ऑलराइट, रिमेंबर दिस. बेस्ड ऑन ग्लोबल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग रेवेन्यू, द मैन्युफैक्चरर्स आर डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री ग्रुप्स, विच आर ग्रुप ए, बी एंड सी. एंड हु आर इंक्लूडेड इन ग्रुप ए? ग्रुप ए में कौन है? सो दोज मैन्युफैक्चरर्स हु हैव GMR, विच मीन्स ग्लोबल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग रेवेन्यू more than or equal to 5000 crores are under group A, while in group B those manufacturers having GMR between 500 crores and 5000 crores, and in group C those manufacturers are included who have GMR less than 500 crores. All right, so these are the three groups under which the manufacturers are divided. And talking about the incentives, so the total incentives that will be provided under this scheme is how much? Approximately rupees 15000 crore. And out of this 15,000 crores, 11,000 crores will be given to group A, 2250 crores will be given to group B, and 1750 crores will be given to group C. All right, so remember these bifurcations of investment and the total incentives also. Bifurcation of incentives and the total incentives, remember both. And also the total incremental sale of 2,94,000 crores, total incremental sale of 2,94,000 crores, and total incremental export of 1,96,000 crore is expected. और ये कब तक के लिए expected है? In the upcoming 6 years till financial year 2028. Financial year 2028 तक ये दो figures government ने expect करे हैं after the implementation of this scheme, which is what? Total incremental sales of 2,94,000 crores and total incremental export of 1,96,000 crore. And remember, for calculating the value of incremental sales, the base year is what? 2019-20. 2019-20 जो है वो base year रखा गया है for calculating the incremental sales. Okay. And moving ahead to the incentives in various category of products. So remember, all the goods under this scheme has been have been divided into three categories. Teen categories mein divide kiya gaya hai. And remember, ye categories mein kya kaun se products hain, that is not important for the exam, that is not worth remembering. So just remember, all the goods in the pharmaceutical sector are divided into three categories. Now under the category one products, 10% incentive will be given for the first 4 years, 8% for fifth year, and 6% for sixth year. In the category two products, same, 10% for 4 year, 8% for fifth year, 6% for sixth year. Okay. While in the category three products, jo first or second ka uska half kar do. It is very easy to remember. 5% for first 4 years, then 4% for fifth year, and 3% for sixth year. Right. So these are the incentives that will be given under the scheme to the category 1, 2, and 3 products under the pharmaceutical sector. Right. So this is about the pharmaceutical sector. Now let's talk about the PLI scheme for IT hardware. IT hardware ki baat karte hain. So it has also been launched with the same objective to boost the domestic manufacturing and attract the investment in the value chain of IT hardware. IT hardware ke sector mein manufacturing ko boost karne ke liye aur investment attract karne ke liye the scheme has been launched. And the targeted segments are four. There are four target segments under this scheme, PLI scheme for IT hardware, which are laptops, tablets, all-in-one PCs, and servers. Laptops, tablets, all-in-one PCs, and servers are the four targeted segments. And the very important thing is that the incentive is ranged from 4% to 2% or 1%. 4% to 2% or 1% on the net incremental sales for a period of 4 years. Ye kitne saalon ke liye hai? 4 saalon ke liye, remember the total year also, for a period of 4 years. And in this also the base year will be what, 2019-20. Jo base year hoga wo kya hoga, 2019-20 hi hoga. And the total outlay for this scheme guys is 7350 crores, and out of this 7350 crores, rupees 7325 crore is for the incentive outlay. It is the incentive outlay, while the rest 25 crore is the administrative charges. All right. Now it has been expected that it will create jobs. And how many jobs are expected to be created by this? It is 180,000 over a period of 4 years. Agle 4 saalon mein is scheme se 180,000 jobs create hongi, as expect kiya hai government dwara. And the scheme guys will provide impetus to the domestic value addition in the IT hardware sector, and it is expected that it will rise to 20% to 25% by the year 2025. All right, so guys, this is about the PLI scheme for both pharmaceutical sector and IT hardware. I hope both the schemes are clear. And now let's come back to question number one and question number two. So the very first scheme is regarding the pharmaceutical sector PLI scheme, and you have to consider these statements and I have to identify correct ones. So the scheme will be implemented for a period from 2021 to 2019-30. No, that is not up to financial year 2030, that is up to financial year 2029, which means 2028-29 only, which means this statement guys is incorrect. And for group A applicants, the total incentive is ₹11,000 crore. This is absolutely correct. While the total incentive that will be given under pharmaceutical sector is approximately how much? 15,000 crores. All right. 15,000 करोड़ रुपए टोटल है, और ग्रुप ए के लिए कितना है? 11,000 करोड़ रुपए. एंड द गुड्स आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू फोर कैटेगरीज. नो, एज आई टोल्ड यू, द गुड्स आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू थ्री कैटेगरीज, कैटेगरी 1, 2 एंड 3. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज आल्सो इनकरेक्ट, एंड वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स. सो देयरफॉर ऑप्शन बी, ओनली टू शुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर, बिकॉज वी हैव ओनली वन स्टेटमेंट व्हिच इज करेक्ट हियर, एंड दैट इज द सेकंड वन. ऑलराइट, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, व्हिच इज अबाउट the PLI scheme for IT hardware, and you have to now identify the incorrect statements. All right. So the total outlay for scheme is ₹7350 crores. This is absolutely correct. And out of this 7350 crores, 7325 will be used for incentives, while the rest 25 crores will be used for the administrative charges. Okay. Total 180,000 jobs are expected to be generated. Correct. And the incentive under the scheme is ranged from 4% to 2%. So guys, this is also correct, which means all the statements are correct here. Sare statement kya hai? Correct hai. Therefore, option D, none is incorrect, should be the correct answer. Okay, so I hope guys this question is clear. And now let's move ahead to question number 3, which is about a summit that was organized by FICCI. So the FICCI Higher Education Summit, and remember it was the 16th edition. It was the 16th edition of FICCI Higher Education Summit. It was inaugurated by Union Education Minister, and we all know who is the Union Education Minister. The event was organized by FICCI in collaboration with two ministries. Which are those two ministries? And let me tell you once again, the Union Education Minister is Dr. Ramesh Pokhariyal Nishank. Ramesh Pokhariyal Nishank's Lok Sabha constituency is Haridwar. Okay. So let's talk about this news. So FICCI Higher Education Summit 2021, the 16th edition, was organized by FICCI. And remember, it was organized by FICCI in collaboration with Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. And who is the Minister for Commerce and Industry? It's Mr. Piyush Goyal. And he is also the Minister for Railways. And he is also the Minister for Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. After the death of Ram Vilas Paswan, he was given this additional charge. All right. And what was the objective of this summit? So it bring together the stakeholders in the education sector for deliberations and discussion regarding the education sector in India. Isme national international logo jo stakeholders hain unka ideas exchange hue, unke jo bhi you know related matter hai, jo bhi matters hai related to education usko discuss kiya gaya basically. And what was the theme? The theme of the summit was higher education at 2030 rise. Higher education at 2030 rise. Remember the theme. This is very important. Is pure ke pure news mein, you just have to remember two, three things only. Number one, it was organized by FICCI in joint collaboration with Ministry of Education and Ministry of Commerce and Industry. And number two, the thing that you have to remember is the theme. Dusri cheez aapko kya yaad rakhni hai? Theme yaad rakhni hai. Aur wo kya hai? Higher education at 2030 rise. And what is the full form of RISE? RISE has a full form also, which is Resilience, Innovation, Sustainability and Enterprise. Resilience, Innovation, Sustainability and Enterprise is the full form of RISE. Okay. So now let's come back to the question. So you have to identify those ministries with which FICCI has organized this event. So these are Ministry of Education and Ministry of Commerce and Industry, which means 1 and 3. Option C, only 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. And who is the chairperson of FICCI? It's Mr. Uday Shankar. Uday Shankar is the chairperson of FICCI, and don't confuse Uday Shankar with Mr. Uday Kotak. Uday Kotak is the chairperson or the president of Confederation of Indian Industry, CII. So don't get confused. And now let's talk about question number 4. Which of the following platform has been launched by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri? He is also the Minister of Civil Aviation and Affairs to connect cities to innovators. So प्लेटफॉर्म लॉन्च किया गया है बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स ताकि जो सिटीज है उनको इनोवेटर्स के साथ कनेक्ट किया जा सके सो दैट द प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू गवर्नेंस इन द सिटीज कैन बी सॉल्व्ड सो रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ दिस प्लेटफॉर्म गाइज इज सिटी इनोवेशन एक्सचेंज व्हाट इज द नेम जस्ट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द नेम एंड द मिनिस्ट्री दैट हैज लॉन्च दिस प्लेटफॉर्म सिटी इनोवेशन एक्सचेंज एंड दिस कैन बी आस्क्ड इन योर वन मार्कर इन योर एग्जाम एंड इट वॉज लॉन्च टू फोस्टर इनोवेशन इन अर्बन एरियाज नाउ व्हाट विल इट डू It will connect the cities to innovators to design innovative solution for their pressing challenges. जो भी challenges cities face करती हैं, उनको खत्म करने के लिए, उनको tackle कराने के लिए, cities को connect करा दिया जाएगा with the innovators so that those challenges can be tackled properly. Okay? And the platform has more than 400 startups, 100 smart cities, more than 150 challenge statements, and over 215 solutions. So in this news, you just have to remember what is the name of the platform. And which ministry has launched this and what is the basic objective of launching this platform. Okay. So therefore the correct answer is what? Option B. City Innovation Exchange. Option B will be the correct answer. All right. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the 4 questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.